Okay, when you run this program, you notice that you don't get the answer there the same, but you get that root squared is a value that's close to 2, but not quite. So there's a tiny error in that computation. These errors are unavoidable because decimal numbers cannot store an infinite number of digits, and somewhere some roundoff is going to happen. So when you compare true numbers with fractional parts, you're never interested in whether they're exactly the same. You want to know, are they close to each other? Or in other words, is the difference small? Now we want to take the absolute value of the difference. We just care, is that a small positive or negative value? Translated into Java, we compute the absolute value of the difference and we compare it against a tiny number. In math, one usually calls a tiny number by the name epsilon. And in many situations, 10 to the minus 12 is a pretty good value to use. Let's do that in our program. Instead of the exact comparison, let's test whether root squared and original are close to each other. That's the test here. And of course, I have to define epsilon using the final keyword to indicate that it's a constant. Now when we run the program, we get the expected result. The takeaway is, whenever you compare two decimal numbers, compare whether they're close enough to each other, not whether they're exactly the same.